So good morning, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Cyprus Entrepreneurship Competition 2020 information meeting. Because of the COVID situation, we are running this meeting online only. I hope you can hear me well. My name is Marios Dikaiakos. I'm professor at the University of Cyprus and director of the Center for Entrepreneurship. And this afternoon we have with us Mrs. Maria Theodorou, who is an officer with the Ministry of Commerce and Industry and Energy of the Republic of Cyprus, our major sponsor and supporter. We also have with us Giorgos Zacharia, who is the president of KAYAK Corporation in Boston, Massachusetts, in the United States. Giorgos belongs to the core team of people who started this competition many, many years ago, 17 years ago, right, Giorgos?
And yeah, it started on a coffee 20 years ago.
Wow, amazing. Yeah. And we also have with us Professor Panikkos Poutziouris, who is a professor of entrepreneurship and rector of the University of Central Lancashire in Cyprus, and who was also a member of the team that ran the competition for many years. So the Cyprus Entrepreneurship Competition, I will say a few things, although you will listen more later. I think it was the first business competition organized at the University of in Cyprus, supported by the University of Cyprus and the Ministry of Commerce, Energy and Industry and Tourism at the time. It was based on the principles of the MIT Entrepreneurship Competition. It ran for many, many years, 14 or 15 times. It stopped around 4 years ago. And recently, the Ministry of Energy, Commerce and Industry suggested that we restart the effort here at the Center for Entrepreneurship. And this is something that we did with great joy, taking on board with us a number of other partners from Cyprus and abroad, sponsors and participants and supporters. I would like just to very briefly to recognize the support of the ministry, as I said earlier, of Navigator Consulting, of PricewaterhouseCoopers, CETA, the IDEA, IDEA, the Incubator Accelerator of Bank of Cyprus, KAYAK, the support of RISE, the Research Center on Interactive Media, Smart Systems and Emerging Technology here in Nicosia, and CYBAN, which is the Cyprus Business Angels Network. We also thank the program of the MBA at the University of Cyprus for their support. So without further ado, I would like to give the floor to Giorgos Zacharia, who, as I said, is along with my colleague and friend, Skevos Evripidou, who is the people who started this competition many years ago. So Giorgos, thanks for being with us from Boston today.
Hi, everyone. As you can see, I wish I was in Protaras, but I am Giorgos. My main job is I'm president at KAYAK. I've been there for almost 12 years. I'm a repeat entrepreneur, started a handful of startups so far. Two of them went through the MIT Entrepreneurship Competition. And the original intent of the competition was to, 20 years ago, was to foster an entrepreneurial ecosystem in Cyprus. Copy the idea from MIT and see if such an event would drive startup generation. A few data points about how successful MIT has been in driving the creation of startups. MIT startups alone, this is a 2014 study, were generating $1.9 trillion in annual revenue. It, back then, it was about 30,000 active companies, 4.6 million employees. If it was a country, it would be the 10th largest economy in the world. And 40% of the MIT founders are repeat entrepreneurs. They do more than one startup. In the, and more interestingly, applicable to Cyprus, 23% of those companies are actually outside the US. So there is a lot of activity already outside the US. So imagine what an accelerant it can be to the Cyprus economy. It will drive more company and job creation through entrepreneurship. So I'm very grateful that the Marios and the industry, and the Minister of Industry are reviving this, and we can see what other ideas can come up through the competition. So why participate in the competition? What's the value to the entrepreneur? The biggest value is that you get to network with other entrepreneurs. You can optimize your team, find the gaps that you have in your team, meet other people that could be part of your founding team. It helps with fundraising because you get exposed to angel investors and institutional investors. And it helps with business development. Some of the teams that you get exposed to, some of the judges, the press that's generated around the winning ideas can drive actual commercial partnerships. You also get to, as a founding team, you also get to test and iterate your ideas with experienced entrepreneurs and investors will give you feedback. You get to learn technicals of financial modeling for your business, the nuts and bolts of financial modeling to be able to present to professional investors. And you pitch, you optimize and repeat through the feedback we give you and that is hopefully constructive. And then there is the awards. You get a non-dilutive if you're the first prize. You get a non-dilutive prize of 10,000 euros that can get you started. And then you get to be hosted by accelerators, incubators, or even a company like KAYAK in the US or in Berlin, where you get to work with other entrepreneurs and other startup people and learn and hopefully help your idea accelerate. So I have.
So thank you very much, Giorgo. Now, Maria, the industry, the Ministry of Commerce, Energy, Industry has been a supporter of this. And we know that the ministry is supporting entrepreneurship in general in Cyprus. So would you like to say a few words? What do you expect of this competition? Why are you supporting it?
Okay. First, I would also like to welcome you all in this e-event. About the Cyprus Entrepreneurship Competition. And I'm really, really happy to be here and relaunch this competition. So the aim of this competition is actually, as the ministry perceives this, is to cultivate actually entrepreneurial culture and spirit among young scientists, and most of all, motivate the youngs to dare and transform actually their ideas into real innovative businesses, starting from the preparation of a viable business plan. Today, what the ministry and the government has to deal today is with a global market that undergoes the bigger probably economic crisis is expected to come in the history. And in this environment, entrepreneurship and entrepreneurial innovation are the most important components, actually, for boosting the economy and enhance its competitiveness. So the main requirement for succeeding this is the quality and the competences, the skills of the human resources. And it's a fact that Cyprus has a wealth of creative and high educated people. And we can actually build in this, but we still need to stimulate the entrepreneurial mindsets of young people and encourage innovative businesses and startups And finally, foster a culture that is friendly to entrepreneurship. In this economic era, the Cypriot business community cannot actually compete until they become more inventive and innovative. So the government, and more specifically the ministry, strongly believe that at this point of time, the best investment we can make is actually on entrepreneurship culture and entrepreneurship in education. We believe that this is actually the investment that will have the bigger return in the future. The most important of the participation in this kind of competitions and events or projects is that the students, over and above what Mr. Zacharia said before, is that the students develop skills. Skills like critical thinking, risk-taking, group work, time management are critical not only for their entrepreneurial future, but also for their professional success in any sector they decide to have their employment in the future. These are skills that are very, very critical for their success, and at the same time are the skills necessary for the youngs to dare and go and make their own business. So that is why the ministry supports and the organization of events like this competition, and will continue to support and promote all forms of innovation, including like technological, organizational innovation in services. Okay, this is actually the expectation of the ministry towards these events. We are really happy, and we would like to congratulate and thanks the organizers and the sponsors, the mentors, and we would especially the Entrepreneurship Center of the university. And we are really happy to see how the competition has evolved and has changed, and we look forward for the results. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Maria, for your thoughtful comments. Of course, the entrepreneurship competition, CYC, has a strong training component, as there is an acceleration phase. And this, we'll say more about this later. And this, you know, is oriented towards young, but also not so young people who want to take up new activities in entrepreneurship. Before I pass the floor to Professor Poutziouris, I would like to remind to our audience who are watching through our YouTube stream that they can put any questions they have either on the YouTube channel of the Center for Entrepreneurship or on slido.com. You must see the URL at the page at the window, Slido window. So slido.com hashtag CYEC2020. This is a platform for submitting questions that will be passed to us, and then we can answer any questions, any clarifications you may have on the competition. So, Panikkos, you have been involved in this for many years. What are the big, observations or the take-home ideas from your experience?
Thank you, Marios, and good afternoon, everybody. I am representing the veterans, or the so-called early enthusiasts, to extend support for this initiative. So it's true that the Cyprus Entrepreneurship Business Plan Competition was launched in the beginning of the millennium. Skevos, Evribidou, George Zacharias, Lida have been the progenitors of the so-called MIT-style initiative. So my role has been to offer the startup business training, and I have also acted as a jury for almost a decade. I was wearing the hat of CIIM Professor of Entrepreneurship, and I was also the visiting associate professor for entrepreneurship at Manchester Business School. So the legacy, as we call it, it's important both for Cyprus, but also for myself, because this kept me in Cyprus, and I did return to Manchester Business School in a visiting capacity, to be honest. So I am very emotional about the impact of the initiative. But allow me maybe also to map out the legacy and the impact of the initiative at various levels. The initiative has been a game changer as it has impacted positively on the anorthosis of the entrepreneurial aspiration of our youngsters, students, scientists across fields. You know, science, engineering, but also business and management and social sciences. But also, we have impacted across frontiers, because if you do an audit of the participants, you realize we had people from Greece, from London, from Ukraine, from India. So the initiative has fostered also the cooperation and what we call interdependence of a number of agents. Who are these agents? It's students, scientists, academics, financiers, business angels, serial entrepreneurs like George Zacharias. And also in those days, we had the proliferation of business incubation centers. So the initiative has brought together aspiring entrepreneurs who got integrated into the scientific and the entrepreneurship clusters of the universities and other research institutions. And these people have developed what we call the entrepreneurial roadmap for their projects, because as part of the CyEC model, the early stage ventures and projects of our participating teams, they got support in terms of the startup business training, mentoring, and guidance on how to work out the winning business plans, but not just for the competition, but also for the marketplace. So over the years, you know, the participation and the initiative provided the impetus for the entrepreneurial ecosystem in Cyprus, because participants, supporters, and the winners have contributed to the development of the entrepreneurial agenda. So what we have witnessed in that period was the integration of entrepreneurship into enterprise policy debate. You know, there has been a shift on the so-called tax regime to enthuse early stage investment. Today, there is a tax efficiency for the investment in innovative companies. Also, we have witnessed the adoption of entrepreneurship in education, in the early stages of the educational cycle. And definitely, in many universities, we did accelerate the development of entrepreneurship education at the business school level. How to start and survive and grow a business. In parallel, we also saw the establishment of the business angel and the enterprise support network. So we are proud that the graduates from the Cyprus Entrepreneurship Business Plan Competition did progress with the establishment of startup firms. And today, some are classified as growth stars. A few names that come to mind, and apologies, I'm not gonna extend the list. We have Engino, Student Life, Paul Fish, Medsonic, and others. So these new generation entrepreneurs are the role models and are to be applauded as they did there to innovate, allowing me to use the lexicon of Skevos Evribidou in the early days. And these entrepreneurs have escaped from what we call the classic employability route. They did not get the job in the civil service or in the big bank or the financial institution. In fact, some of them, they left their job in the civil service. So this is a credit to the initiative. These entrepreneurs, they have pursued the entrepreneurial journey and they have built value creation and generated innovative solutions, new ventures, and above all, they created jobs. And if you review the situation at the macro level, the success of the Cyprus Entrepreneurship Competition has impacted on the improvement of the performance of Cyprus in the global entrepreneurship monitor indicators. And as a conclusion, and Gataglidi, allow me to borrow some words from Henry Ford, who is the so-called solid economy entrepreneur. He said, coming together is a beginning. Staying together is progress, and working together is success. So best wishes to the regenesis of the Cyprus Entrepreneurship Competition Initiative. For continued success and more achievements, it is vital that we keep working together to inspire more people to innovate, to wake up so that they can realize their entrepreneurial dreams. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Panikko. This is very interesting. I mean, this retrospective view of what the competition has achieved throughout the years. Of course, I think now the conditions are much better for the people who participate. You know, it's amazing that since 2000, now we have several universities, many research centers. The number of researchers that produce research has grown substantially. The funding available, as you mentioned, is there. Whereas in when this started, I mean, the conditions were not so easy. I think not that now it's easy, but I mean, still there are a lot of many more opportunities, both in Cyprus as well as in the European Union. So thank you again. We have several questions. Before we go into the questions, I would like just to give a brief overview of the competition structure. So the competition is goes in two stages. We have the first stage where people are expected to submit an executive summary of their idea. And they can do this through the website of the competition, which is cyec.org.cy. Then the judging committee, which comprises entrepreneurs from Cyprus and abroad with a lot of experience in different fields, both in creating companies, in running companies, and in funding companies. So this team will pick and select the most promising proposals, and the teams that will be selected will be invited to participate in an acceleration program, which has been announced on our website and which will provide opportunities to the teams to improve their proposal and to improve their business plan and to be ready to present it in front of the judges. So the next step would be the competition itself, where these teams will present in front of the judges. The judges will select the winners. And then during the ceremony, where the winners would be announced, the teams will be, all teams will be invited to present short pitches in front of the audience. So let me get to the questions as they come from Slido and the YouTube. The first question is from someone who is an international student from India pursuing a PhD here in Cyprus, and he's asking or she is asking if they are eligible to participate in the competition. And I think the answer is clear. The answer is yes. Because for a team to participate in the competition, you need to have at least one resident in the Republic of Cyprus. So, yes. A second question, and please feel free, Maria, Panikko, Giorgo, if you have anything to add in these answers, please feel free.
Marios, in relation to the early question, it's important that we see the multidisciplinary and the multinational synthesis of the team. We don't want to see, you know, just, you know, five Cypriots or three Indians alone. You know, it's important that we have that pool of talent and the network and the culture and values and vision, of course. Thank you.
Thank you. This is very important indeed. I would rephrase it in the sense that the team that has people bringing together different perspectives is usually more strong, right? So by all means, I mean, this is not only for Cypriots, but it's for people who, I mean, they have to have at least one person residing in Cyprus. So a second question is technical. Okay, I see someone says an application that needs to be filled. Where do I need to send the application? You send it by email. So you fill the application, you complete the answers to the questions given, and you email it to the address that is given in the website. Someone says if they can add the technical drawing as an appendix, yes, they can. So that's again clear. Now, another question, which I think everybody has it, is whether the target market is important. Namely, do they need to target a specific domain, or do they need to target the Cypriot or the EU market to sell the product or service? Giorgo, would you like to comment on that?
Yeah, so it could be either, right? You can have a healthy business that is targeting only the Cypriot market. You can obviously, scale matters. If it's a global idea, you can have like Porfish, you can be successful globally, even better. But we will evaluate independently of what the target market is, as long as there is a healthy business to be had.
Okay, thank you. I think that's clear. We had a couple of questions asking if a team can comprise only one person. Okay, and I mean, this is reasonable.
Not a team.
Not a team, exactly. But why not a team? Can you explain it, please? I mean, out of your experience.
Yeah, actually, there is quantifiable data about this. There's another MIT study, MIT Sloan study. There is a strong positive correlation of probability of success of a startup given the number of co-founders. Two co-founders are generally more successful than one, and it goes all the way to six co-founders, and then they stop collecting data beyond that. But the more the co-founders, the higher the probability of success. And probably the reason is that, well, they complement each other. They complement each other in terms of skills, but also in terms of psychology. Starting a business is very, it has a lot of up, and it's a very stormy experience. And when somebody's down, maybe the others pull them up. So the bigger the team is, actually, the higher the probability of success.
Teams. It's clear that teamwork is very important in this domain. It's not one man or one woman show. Another question that we have is again, this is technical, whether all members of the team should be present at the final presentation, or I would extend the question, all members of the team, are they expected to be in all stages of the acceleration program? Paniko, maybe out of your experience here with participating in these accelerator programs, previous accelerator programs, what would you say?
You're on mute.
Paniko, can you unmute your microphone, please?
Yes, I beg your pardon. In my view, the more people participating, the better it is for the team. But in today's world, yes, probably not everybody will contribute on equal terms to a startup. If somebody wants to be a more small minority, you know, and they have already a PhD or two MBAs, they could be exempted, but it's important that they show commitment for the initiative. So I don't have an exact metric to define this. And we will be using flexibly technology that will facilitate, I suppose, people to enthuse the participation of the team, yeah?
Thank you. Thank you. That's clear. Giorgos, would you like to add something?
Well, we don't have to see the whole team, but we should see more than one person, obviously. That shows commitment that it is more than one person. And the team should explain what the roles of each member is and what the role of each member is and how they complement and help each other.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, so again, the message is commitment. Namely, if you have a team of four people that passes through the first stage and nobody shows up in the acceleration, and then maybe they, you know, they have a good proposal, then they are invited to present their idea, and just one person shows up, this doesn't show so much commitment to the competition, to the initiative. That's okay, of course. However, commitment is an aspect that would, I guess, would be taken into consideration by the judges, right? So it may affect your success if you don't show commitment. At least this is how I interpret it. But again, this is up to the judges to judge. And I think this answers another question, whether all members of the team should be present at the final presentation. Yes, there should be some good representation, not just one person, to show the commitment. There is another question about, which is very reasonable, I guess everybody has this, whether the acceleration program will take place in afternoons or in the mornings, because some people work. Yes, we understand that. So we will try to we have scheduled everything in the afternoon. And also due to the COVID situation, people ask whether, this would be in person or it would be done via teleconference. So again, the answer there is not easy. Ideally, we would like to have it in person just because the personal interaction, usually gives a lot of good insights to the people. I mean, they have the flexibility to establish contacts. So acceleration is not just about knowledge transfer. But it is more about discussion, about connections, about networking, which happens often impromptu during the coffee breaks, etc. However, we have legal restrictions because in order to, to cope with the pandemic, there is a restriction in how many people can get together, whether we can do open events or not. And therefore, we believe that most of the events will be done online. Although we would wish to try to organize something in person. Now, this depends, of course, on the people who will get to the second stage, how many teams will be accepted, how many people will be in those teams, and so on. So, I mean, our intention is to provide the online option and do it in the afternoons, in Cyprus time, of course, and have some opportunities for person-to-person meetings. I must say, I mean, this gives me the opportunity to also mention that we have a group of mentors and who are volunteers, and they have candidly accepted to provide their, their expertise to the teams. So after the first phase, we are going to do a matching process and bring in contact the mentors with the teams. So then they can connect through teleconference or through personal meeting if they are available. Uh, Okay, another question is a bit technical. I'm an international student. I want to ask regarding resident of Cyprus. Do you mean Cypriot or an international student residing in Cyprus? I think that's clear. Anyone who is a legal resident is welcome to participate. Okay, so I think this is clear. Another question, if there is any limit for the valuation of the project, do you prefer small, easy business or large startup with an international focus and a big upfront cost? We had such questions before. So, and that's natural. People say, you know, I have this idea. Does this fit with you? I don't know, George, Giorgos, would you like to reply?
It should be a startup. If it's an existing business generating revenue that's already funded and it's worth $20 million, I don't think that counts for the scope of this competition. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If it is a business that wants to pivot to something else, to create a new product or a new service, is this acceptable?
Yeah, I think so. If you are in doubt, send us an email and we'll let you know.
Okay.
Marios, if I bring an example over the years, it could be a holding. There is a family business there. You know, there are 27 cousins in terms of the next generation. Obviously, some of them would like to start a new venture. As long as they register the venture and is independent enough from the holding, it qualifies. But we need to see that independence. Otherwise, it's unfair if they get, you know, full blessing and support and somebody else commissions the market research for them. It violates the ethos of the competition, yeah?
Okay, yeah, I think that's clear. And do we have, maybe that was asked before, but maybe it's good to reiterate, do we have any particular areas of technology or market that, I mean, we are strongly interested in or not? I mean, Maria, would you like to comment? I mean, what are the, if there are any areas of priority?
Yeah, I don't think we should at this point define any priority areas. The scope is to have a viable, innovative business. And from that stage and above, I think it should be open.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Regarding the sectoral, yes.
Yes. And regarding the SME versus startup, because usually people, you know, think of startup as something that scales exponentially and very fast.
Yes, and, but you know, still startups. I mean, the rhythm and the way a new company will evolve, it's of course directly linked to its success and its viability. But at this point, I think startups or any other new companies are eligible. New ideas. Mm-hmm. I mean, existing SMEs should not be.
Okay.
In the same concept, I mean, Mrs. Poutziouris explained before.
Yes. Another question is whether do we have a how to say a priority or of innovation versus market, namely, you know, some ideas come and they are very innovative, or they have a very innovative product or technology that they want to work, and maybe their market is not so clear, or is their market research is not so mature, and then you have other proposals that are more oriented to what you have in the market now, so they do not have like a very strong or a deep innovation proposal, but they have a very solid business plan with some new ideas. I mean, do you think that there is, a priority, or it depends on the quality of both proposals?
Yes, I believe the quality of both, because we're not supposed to evaluate positive, like an idea with no market or no product. I mean, to have a product, you need a market. If you don't have a market at all, it's not just to be innovative, it's innovative product with a market potential. So a balance.
Yeah, Giorgio, would you like to comment more on this?
Yeah, I agree. We look at the totality of things. An innovative product that nobody wants to pay for, what's the point? And so, but that is a nice quote from Buffett that says, great teams or great ideas don't matter if the industry is bad. You have to, yeah, there has to be an actual market for the idea.
Okay, thank you. Another question is, how many teams will be accepted in the second stage? I don't think we have a set number, but maybe you want to comment on that.
Yeah, it depends on the quality. I think we'll look, yeah, this is not the playoffs. We'll look at all the ideas and pick up the best ones.
Okay, thanks. That's clear. Can one submit two applications? We had a couple of questions like that. You know, or people say, can I participate in two teams? I mean, these are two different questions. Maybe the same team may have two ideas, or one person may participate in two teams.
Yeah, we have seen that in the past as well. And if you're part of four teams, you're probably not committed to any of them. Maybe you're part of two, so it can. I would not encourage it. At the end of the day, you have to convince us that it's an idea and a project we are committed to.
Mm-hmm. So one thing that many entrepreneurs say it's that is important to focus, right?
Yeah.
On one thing, or take one thing at a time. Is there a number or a maximum number of applicants that would pass on to the next stage? I think we replied that. Right? So we don't have a maximum. Of course, we cannot cope with, 30 teams of five people, but I mean, we'll see. Another question, we have a product costing millions to build up. So the valuation of the project is much more bigger. Is it okay to submit?
Marios, if I
yes, please.
You know, a startup venture could creatively outsource to somebody else the production and concentrate on the road to the market. So yes, in principle, yes, they can go ahead, but it will not be realistic if they contemplate to set up a Goliath type of a factory in Bila, where I am now, to manufacture. No, nowadays you have people that they outsource, you know, to other countries, and they need to demonstrate that they can command, you know, what we call the supply chain, for example. Thank you.
Thank you. That's clear. Okay, another set of questions that we got beforehand. Maybe it's good to mention here. Where around? What do you expect to see? You know, in a business plan. Okay, there is an application form. But what do you want to see in this application form or in the pitch? What do you want us to say? What would be the answer to this? I mean, it's we have given an answer, but you know, I'm not sure if I wanted to hear your opinion as well. Maybe you can start.
Yeah, I would like to see a specific idea that the team has done research about the market opportunity, why that team is the right team to pursue it, and that they understand that there is a market. It's undefined. There is no definitive prescription, but you have to convince us that's going to be a viable startup, in that you are the team that is going to run this.
Yeah. Panikkos?
I mean, the innovative, viable venture, it's important. And then, you know, to convince that they can cope with this, you know, they can put together the right team, they know how to play on the supply side and the demand side, how they will go about funding, how they will take it to the market. If it's, say, business to consumers and they will do it, they need to demonstrate that creativity, even branding the project, you know, because there are instant successes. You know, the way you brand and you name, even your website. So everything counts, depending on what is the focus of the venture, yes?
Yes. Maria, would you like to comment? I mean, sometimes, you know, these questions come from the perspective that usually the government, when they have to, you know, evaluate some application, there are very strict rules, there are very strict and very clear standards that one needs to follow. I mean, is this the entrepreneurial regime or it's something else?
It's true what they say, but usually what we do, we try to fulfill criteria given for to us by the EU. So at this case, this is not in the case actually. So what I would say is a concrete, viable product or a service. Innovation is very important. The passion of the participants is very important. Their commitment, I mean, this is could be the most important of all, because usually what we see is that if someone is committed to a product or a service, usually they find the way. I mean, even if they have marketing problems or operational problems with the product, if they are committed and they have passion about this, they will find the solution.
So the criteria, I think, are quite clear, but they are qualitative.
Yes.
What we said to, you know, people that were asking for some very specific answers, we said, I mean, you have to impress the judges. And the way you impress them, it's up to you, because different ideas can really impress people with totally different ways and on totally different things. So we cannot dictate or we cannot define standards for this. I mean, this is why it's also an innovation competition. I mean, it's we're asking for innovative business plans and not textbook, I guess, right? Because the textbook is available to anyone, right?
And if we, sorry, if I cannot, if we go through and have some quantitative criteria, then I think we will lose the passion of the commitment of the participants, because these are not easy to quantitate.
Yes. Them. Yes. Yeah. Okay. This I mean gives me also the opportunity to reiterate on the awards, and maybe we can talk a little bit about what the awards offer. So. The competition is offering three prizes. The first prize is 10,000 euros, the second prize is 6,000 euros, and the third prize is 4,000 euros. I think this is quite nice prizes, I mean, given that they are cash. And we thank the Ministry of Commerce, Energy and the Industry for their support, and we also thank Navigator Consulting, who is also providing monetary awards. But we have also other awards, and maybe, I mean, it's nice to talk about them too. So another award is hosting in kayak facilities in Cambridge, Massachusetts or Berlin for 1 to 3 months. Second is hosting in RISE, the Research Center Interactive Media Smart Systems Emerging Technologies for again 6 to 12 months. Or hosting a third in Navigator Consulting for up to 6 months in Limassol, including mentoring and business development support. Another award is from the IDEA Incubator Accelerator, which will offer, and Angela Panagiotou, who is also a member of the team of judges, I think she's following us from YouTube, they will offer some participating teams entry to their business acceleration program in their sixth cycle of acceleration. And finally, last but not least, the three winners of the CYC competition will be able to pitch their business plans to CYBAN, to members of CYBAN. CYBAN is the Cyprus Business Angels Network. So. Are these awards important? I mean, is it important for a team to be hosted in Kayak or in Rice or in Navigator? What are they going to gain? I mean, what is your experience, Giorgo, in Boston? And you are one of the proposers of these awards.
Yeah, so we have hosted startups both in Boston and Berlin in the past. And we actually have about 5 startups at any given time in our office in Cambridge. And it's environment, the fact that you are in Cambridge, the center of startup activity in Massachusetts. People, startups who come and find value in that are startups who are looking to expand in the US. And they come for business development, but also to meet investors and just be part of this ecosystem.
Thank you. So access is very important. I mean, you know, very often people don't realize that, but the more you get involved into these activities, you realize how difficult it is to have access to people with real knowledge, experience, to be close to technology like RISE, to have the opportunity to be together with like-minded ideas in accelerator programs like IDEA, to be able to pitch in front of investors. So, I mean, the competition is not the end of a journey. It's not even the beginning of a journey for many people. It's just one step in a journey. And I think the networking is very important, and we are very grateful to all the people that contribute voluntarily to this effort through you know, their personal time or through funding or through access and support. Okay, I don't see any other questions online. And maybe, you know, we could finish this with some closing statements if you wish. Maria, would you like to say something at the end?
Yes, actually, I would like to call for all the students or young entrepreneurs that are thinking about participating to dare and participate. This is the first step. I wish you, of course, all the success to the competition.
Thank you very much, and thanks. We thank the ministry for its support. Panikkos?
You're welcome.
Panikkos, can you unmute? We cannot hear you.
Yes, sir. Let's enjoy the journey. It's always enjoyable when we get to witness, you know, the early stage of ventures. And one suggestion, when the so-called Ministry of Health protocol allows it, maybe to organize a kind of an alumni get together.
Yes.
So that, you know, the new interested aspiring entrepreneurs can also meet people that they have been through this, because the value of networking, it's amazing. So all the best, thank you.
Thank you very much. And Giorgo, would you like to?
I'm very excited that we are reviving this competition. Thank you, Marios, and the ministry. On a personal note, I would like to encourage particularly academics to explore this. I thought I was gonna be an academic, and now I'm addicted to startups. So there's nothing like building products that you can put in the hands of millions of people.
Okay, thank you very much. I would like to thank the audience. Because of restrictions with Zoom, we could not have people in Zoom, but from the questions we received, I understand that a lot of people were following us and we had actually a lot of questions. If you don't mind, we're recording this, I believe, and we can put it later on YouTube so people who didn't have the opportunity to watch to see it later and in the recorded video on YouTube. And with that, I would like to thank you all very much for your presence today. I would like to thank all the supporters and sponsors and all the volunteers that are helping in this competition. We have been, as they say, we stand on the shoulders of giants. I mean, people started this many years ago when, you know, entrepreneurship innovation was not in fashion. here in Cyprus, and I would like again to recognize, you know, their contribution, primarily of Professor Skevos Evripidou, of Mrs. Lida Maldapita, of Giorgos Zacharia, and other people that, you know, I cannot mention now, or even I don't know them, but I mean, it is very important that they started and they sustained this for so many years. Because I mean, here in Cyprus, very often we want to have a easy and fast success, but in reality, success comes with iteration, with persistence, with perseverance, and this has to go on for many years so that we have important impact. So thank you again, and I wish you a nice afternoon or a good morning in Boston. Bye-bye.
Thank you, bye.
Bye.